What's up, people?
Back with another reaction, back with some more Tears for Fears,
and I'm very excited to start going through their The Seeds of Love album. I believe it's 1989. I did remember the title track, or just about the title track, Sowing the Seeds of Love. That's one that I remembered hearing back when I was younger, and I sort of remembered the lyrics a little bit more than the sonics, but for the most part, I don't remember any of the other tunes on this album. I did react to Woman in Chains, although that was part of the Rule the World 2017 compilation. But the one other tune besides Sowing the Seeds of Love, I sort of remember at least by name, is the tune we're going to listen to, which is Advice for the Young at Heart. This name does strike a chord, but I can't really think of the tune. Now, if I remember the song enough to remember the name, I'm guessing once it starts there might be some familiar elements. But I can't remember the lyrics, I can't recall them, so I can't really speak to any themes before the song begins, but please let me know. I know a lot of you Tears for Fears fans have incredible knowledge, not just of the songs and the composition of the album, but sort of the way in which their history as a group has informed some of their songwriting. And someone was recently talking about a song where it's on one of the two albums where Roland was, you know, carrying the Tears for Fears name by himself after Kurt had left, and there's a song that I don't know if they were saying that people didn't realize originally, or maybe it was just it only came to light. I'm trying to remember if I'm getting this right, but basically I think Roland wrote a song that was very critical of Kurt for having left, maybe it was Kurt that didn't realize this until much later, but yeah, again, a lot of you have some incredible information. If I'm missing anything or if I'm like incorrectly stating something, don't hesitate to correct me. I'd rather be corrected than be wrong. So yeah, big ups to all you Tears for Fears fans. I really appreciate you. Let's get to it. This is Advice for the Young at Heart. From their 1989 album, The Seeds of Love, and we'll see if I do indeed recall this. I'm not, like, remembering it so far, but I like that, really fast percussive layer. Smooth kind of jazz feel a little bit. Okay. And that could be not age related specifically, but like your sentiment. Are you young at heart or not? Like the first line, I was like, all right, the souvenir, I'm not like, oh man. It's like once received in any way, even if it's later like lost, it's always like linked to that experience. Thank you. that kind of angelic, sort of like floating on top of the rest of the track. That string layer got really powerful there. It's interesting, like, it's not making me recall hearing it on the radio, so I don't know, maybe I just saw the name somewhere. Oh, it's a song by Tears of Fear. I didn't actually hear it, I don't know. But I love it, it's fantastic. It's like, again, like, jazzy is only like part of it. Someone mentioned when I reacted to a Badman's song that they really take you to church. Maybe not as much here, but feel a similar sort of atmosphere. It's like rejuvenative, it's uplifting, uplooking. We can do anything. And like even you have the organ there, almost kind of like a church organ. Oh, the piano's thing.
Anything that we
sort of a carpe diem sentiment, that we could do anything, we just have to actually do it, just seize the day, stay young at heart. Again, you know, maybe there's other elements there that I missed out on or I'm sort of, you know, failing to appreciate, but like I said, shout it out. Please let me know if you have some interesting information on this one, either lyrically or musically. I'd like to hear that one again, and Badman's song. Both of those songs were sort of like journeys. The Badman song, I mean, if you watch the reaction, I literally, there was twice where I thought like, wow, it's ending, what a masterpiece, oh, it's not over, oh, wow. And then it did it again, and so then by the third time, or when it actually ended, I was like, wait, are we really over? But this one, even though I don't think it was quite as long, it still felt like a journey, and it sort of, as I said, it felt rejuvenative and sort of uplifting and sort of, you know, soaring into the heavens. Yeah, and again, like, from what I did pick up from the lyrics, it does seem like there was something to that idea of, you know, whatever your actual age, if you can remain young at heart, then the world is your oyster, you can do whatever you set your mind to. So yeah, I really enjoyed it, let me know what you think. Looking forward to going through the rest of this album. I think there are 9 songs overall, is that right? Yeah, there's 9. No, 8. It says 8. Interesting. So there's only 8 songs, which, you know, there's nothing wrong with that, especially if a couple of the songs are longer. But I don't think I realized there were that few tracks. I thought there was, like, you know, 9 at least, or maybe 10. But yeah, I've reacted to a few of them now. So the first 4 have been reacted to, meaning I have the back, you know, slightly more than half of the album. So yeah, let me know if there's another song that remains that you're particularly looking forward to. None of the names are standing out to me here. Standing on the Corner of the Third World, though, without, you know, not really remembering that tune, that is just a very evocative title, a very suggestive title, and one that I can't wait to get to, because as I've come to learn, and as multiple people have commented, you know, they have very passionately held views, not just about, you know, emotions and their own lives, but about society and politics and about, you know, attitudes in the world, and I really respect that, and it, you know, it seems like a lot of their views resonate with my own, which sort of warms my heart even more. So yeah, big ups to them, and I'm really looking forward to that, which incidentally is the next tune. So yeah, hopefully you're here for it. Let me know if you are. Thank you for listening and watching. I will see you next time. Peace.